Welcome back to Zen Crypto. In today's content, we're going to talk about Bitcoin, and we're also going to take a look at ICX on the two-day time frame, and on the high degree, on the high time frame also. All right, but let's start off with Bitcoin. All right, so when you take a look at Bitcoin, it doesn't look like it is actually that bearish. As you can see, the two-day time frame right here, it is pretty engulfing, and you guys know I like the two-day time frame. It gives me the directional move. All right, so pretty engulfing two-day time frame does not mean a bearish setup. Okay, it only means a correction. So we've been anticipating some sort of a rejection just by 59 to 61. Remember, 59 to 61 was our ultimate target when BTC was at 57 right here, but it dipped down to the two-day 21 EMA. Price action got a beautiful support at 43. We pumped to the upside all the way up to 57, 58. In our premium group, what we said, do not long it above this range of 58, because it could still consolidate somewhere around 59 to 62 area. So we just been focusing on alt, like FET, CHR, COIT, and so on, storage, RSR, and all that good stuff. Because Bitcoin, you take a look at it, guys, over the last 3 weeks, okay, it's only up 30%. Okay, some of these alt over the last 3 weeks, they're up 300%, 400%, and all of that good stuff. That's why we haven't been basically focusing on Bitcoin, just been focusing on the focusing on alt, moonshot, and all of that good stuff. But going back to BTC, the type of potential correction we could get over the next few days is we could get the flat correction right here. As I said, when Bitcoin was right here, we said even if we pump back up to 59 to 61, we still got a potential retest of the mid 45Ks. Okay, but we're gonna take a look at it once we get the confirmation of a potential retest of the mid 40K and all of that good stuff. We're basically gonna take a look at it. But as of now, one thing we just have to keep in mind, the range right here, it is just consolidative, okay? So now let's take a look at the 6 hour time frame and 8 hour time frame, okay? When you take a look at the 6 hour and 8 hour time frame, you can clearly see in terms of wave analysis, you could argue, okay, it is a 5 wave ending diagonal right here. That's possible, and you could be looking for a move all the way down to 0.618 or even down to 0.786 and all of that good stuff, right? But the 21 EMA right here, all right, is not responding as we've been expecting. Yesterday we talked about the 6 hour 21 EMA going to be our first line of defense, and as long as we're above it, we're bullish. And as you can see, we broke the 21 EMA right here engulfingly, so that's not good, at least in the short term. Okay, price action below 21 EMA, MACD already crossed bearish, so that's not a good sign within the next a few hours and so on, right? So any pump to the upside could be just a short opportunity for most of the at least for most of the bears. They're going to be basically shorting this sucker, looking for the double top or even another retest right here and a triple top, just consolidate, as I said, in this range. Okay, so if we do not get the consolidation, one thing we could get, guys, is just a dip down. Okay, once again, it can still consolidate right on the lower degree right here and still dip down. You see what I'm saying? So timing going to play a crucial role. Okay, we just don't know the how long it's going to take to drop down here if we're going to be correcting. Do you see what I'm saying? So the correction could last for a while before we drop down here with lower lows and lower highs right here before the potential retracement down to the mid 45Ks and so on, right? Once again, mid 45Ks is not bearish. It only means alt going to be pumping. Okay, mid 50Ks, mid 40, down to mid 45Ks only means alt are likely to give us a moonshot. Okay, so something to keep in mind. All right, so immediate target to keep an eye on. Yesterday, immediate support was 57, 50, 56. Now, immediate target going to be our 6 hour right here, our 6 hour 100 EMA. It is at 51, 52 area, okay? 51 to 52 level, you take a look at it, it is just about 0.61, just about 50% to 0.618 at the same time. So something to keep in mind, we talk about it during our live stream. So something to keep in mind, keep an eye on your 6 hour 100 EMA over the next like a few hours and so on, right? So now let's go ahead and take a look at ICX. So ICX, I'm loving ICX. As you can see, the type of structure we're looking from, we're looking to create on BTC. We already got that structure on ICX, all right? Take a look at it. That's the type of structure we got on BTC right here, the double top. ICX already got the double bottom right here. So that's the type of a double bottom we could anticipate from BTC right here going down to like a mid 45K and so on. So ICX moonshot is clean, okay? We could get the moonshot over the next like a few days and so on. So ICX is a good hold going into like a Q2 and so on, right? So now let's take a look at ICX on the 2 day time frame, right? You can see like the cleanness of the bullish setup, and we could wait for confirmation regarding like the breakout on a 2 day basis, right? However, right, one of the reasons why I don't want to wait for a confirmation is like I like the sell volume right here, how low the sell volume is on the downtrend. Remember, whenever you get a flat correction, right, most of the time, right, let's say sucker pump all the way up to like some crazy prices, dip down, right? Let's change the color and dip down right here, right? In, do it in red, right? Right, and then get another pump right here, right? Let's do that in yellow, right? Because it is still correcting. And you could anticipate what? Another red to the downside, right? Right here, right? That's what I call double top, double bottom. It is a flat correction. Sometimes it can be overextended, it can be expanded and all of that good stuff. But one thing you gotta remember is just a double top, double bottom. It doesn't have to be, I'm not looking for accuracy, okay? I'm just looking for a pattern. Sometimes sucker can look like something like that, okay? It can break the top, break the bottom, but you know, visually you just want to look for the shape, not the price level, okay? So you take a look at ICX, pretty much same thing. But what I try to explain to you guys is like the second drop right here, you want to see it like a low volume, okay? You want the second correction to be a low volume. If that's the case, you could, you know, get the, you know, could say, hey, I got a confirmation, the move right here is just a correction. The volume is dropping, price is retesting the EMAs and all of that good stuff. We could potentially see a huge breakout over the next like a few days and so on. I'm gonna give you guys a clean example, okay, before we talk about the target to the upside, right? Let's take a look at ENG BTC, right, before the breakout. So you take a look at ENG BTC, I said it, I showed you guys cleanly, all right? Before the breakout right here, during our live stream, I said sucker could be pumping all the way up to where? 3,000, right? To 3,700 right here. And sucker was at 1,000. So sucker pump basically 3X. And right now you can see like we already updated, you know, the sucker could potentially pump to our next like a resistance level, 6,500 up to basically, even like, a, you know, 7,000 sats and all of that good stuff. So we could potentially see the same exact move from ICX. Another good example is like HBAR, okay? So HBAR, I also updated my premium group before the breakout right here. As you can see, sucker basically, it was one of our top pick back in January when sucker was like 100 sats. So we're killing it, guys. We're killing it in our premium. These are life, you know, life changing opportunities. You buying at 100 sats, you selling at 2000 sats, 3000 sats and all of that good stuff, right? So you take a look at HBAR, same exact setup, okay? Same exact setup right here. So do this. HBAR BTC, okay? So right here, So if you take a look at our setup in our premium group, each bar was at the with the double top double bottom type of structure I just showed you. You can see like we've been anticipating sucker to pump all the way up to guys to like what 800 sats. Right now you take a look at each bar, it already pumped all the way up guys to like a 750 and so on. So let's take a look at the previous setup before the moonshot. Right here, so that's our previous setup before the moonshot. Okay, H bar was like somewhere around like 200 sat and all of that good stuff, right? So we started buying at the very bottom regarding H bar. Okay, so now let's go back to H bar ICX moonshot and what type of structure we could anticipate from ICX. Okay, so when you take a look at ICX, once again we got the double top double bottom. Okay, what are we looking for? It is pretty clean. All right, we're looking for the rejection at April 2019 prices. Okay, sucker could pump all the way up to like a 0.6 over 0.618 also at September 2018 prices right there, which is like 14,000 sats, right? So but we're mainly going to focus on like 11,000 to 12,000 sats. If you take a look at it from a current price level, sucker could be pumping another basically guys 200%, and we've been buying ICX at the very bottom at 1300 sats, 1400 sats, and we're looking for like 14,000 sats. That's the 10x. So ICX could blast off over the next like a few days. A great hold. Wouldn't be selling it, wouldn't be day trading it and all of that good stuff, right? So guys, that's all I wanted to cover for today. So if you enjoyed the content, you know exactly guys what to do. Don't forget to hit the like, subscribe to the channel, join my public Telegram group, link in the description. We're gonna see some massive gains from these alt. All right guys, make sure to let me know which alt you want me to include in my next update. If you want me to update any top alt or any low cap alt and all of that good stuff, let me know in the comment section. All right guys, thanks a lot for watching.